Do you believe that war or the organized destruction of infrastructure and institutions is likely to be initiated by right-wing extremists? Could you address the fact that if so, the extremists have infiltrated the military, police departments, National and Coast Guard, have trained militia groups worldwide, own the majority of the guns? What do you think would be the outcome? Do you believe that Americans who are against extremism are willing to sacrifice their comforts for a political cause? It's one thing to hashtag, another to quite possibly die. Thanks for your insight. It's a little depressing to think about, to be honest. But it is something I do think we have to think about. What we're witnessing right now across the country, and this is something that is definitely not getting enough play, we're seeing extremists attacking power grids. Okay, this isn't something happening in a far-off third world country that you couldn't even locate on a map. It's happening right here in the United States right now. That's a terrifying thought, you know, attacking these power stations. And of course, we're seeing it emerge as, oh, it's right-wing extremists again, because it always is right-wing extremists doing these kinds of things. But I also think deep down, these people are cowards. Not just the ones attacking the power stations, but when you look at these Republicans, the ones who are heavily armed, the ones who talk a big game on social media, deep down, they're cowards. That's what they are. You know, the ones who travel across state lines, heavily armed, fighting off people who are unarmed. That's what a coward does. So those folks I'm not too much worried about. To your other point, though, this is what does concern me. We have seen report after report, actually going all the way back through the Bush administration, of these violent right-wing extremists rising through the ranks of the military, rising through the ranks in the police force, usually after leaving the military. We just got reports about the Boogaloo Boys, you know, in these federal law enforcement agencies, overwhelming numbers of them. That is a problem. Those people who have been trained by the United States military, those people who are getting weapons issued to them by the United States military, those people do keep me up at night. The thought of what these folks could do if they so chose, and based on their extremist views, we can't rule that out. So that is something, again, that does keep me up at night. That is something that is very terrifying to think about, but it's something we do have to think about. And as I mentioned, this is a problem that actually goes back to the Bush administration. So here's what happened during the Bush administration that kind of led us to where we are today. During that time, and we covered this on the early days of Ring of Fire here, the Bush administration was having a very serious problem with military recruitment. Nobody wanted to go off and die in his unwinnable war based on lies. So what they did was they lowered the criteria and cut back on the screening of people applying to be in the military, which led to an influx of white supremacists, of anti-government extremists, all these people who previously would be rejected for military service started getting in. And once you get that military experience, assuming you're not dishonorably discharged, that leads to all of these other roles in the United States government, right? Like you can go work at the Homeland Security offices a lot easier if you've got a distinguished military background than if you're a civilian off the street. You can become a police officer a hell of a lot quicker if you've served in the military than if you're just somebody fresh out of high school or college. Military service is looked upon very, very favorably here in the United States, especially with positions inside the government, whether it's local, state, or federal. So all those people during the Bush years, those extremists who got in, got those credentials, took it, ran with it. I don't think, by the way, that we ever re-strengthened those restrictions on military recruitment. So as far as I know, it's still a thing. And reports suggest that it is still a thing. Very terrifying, very real possibility of you know, issues coming from that. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, Don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.